Here is a quick shooting and overview video of the WeTech TT33, aka the Tokarev. Hope you enjoy. It's pretty noisy, even over the drone of the furnace in my basement here. So I fire a total of 12 shots here with propane. The basement temperature is about 20 degrees Celsius. I get an average FPS of 250. This sounds a little bit low. I think maybe I have the hop up on too high, or maybe the air seal's a little bit off, but it does stay pretty consistent after that first shot, which is nice. Oh, this is with 0.2 gram BBs. So overall, it's a pretty nice piece. Has some decent weight to it. It's all metal. You can see that there are some serial numbers on it, fake ones. The grips are plastic. There are no other trademarks on this, by the way. Other side, you can see it's pretty simple there, it just has that clip to hold it down. There's a sling loop on both the magazine and the bottom of the grip there, more serial number stuff on the top and Cyrillic. It's got a pretty simple sight picture there. That's pretty standard for your World War II guns, though. That's the annoying safety. This is not featured on the real one at all. We just added it. Blocks the trigger. It's very, very easy to push down by accident, like when you're pulling it from the holster, so you constantly have to check it. Here's the magazine. It can hold up to 15, but I'd say load it to 14. Otherwise, you might break your nozzle. It can get through a full 14 rounds on one charge of gas, even more actually. Now, you cannot slingshot or power stroke this at all. The only way is to hit the slide release. Not super tactical, I know, but this is old, remember. I have to say it's pretty small compared to the 1911. I wear medium-sized gloves, and it does feel smaller comparatively. Shake test, it's a little bit rattly. It is all metal though, and you can't really see a gap between the slide and the frame. The trigger on this is light and incredibly short. There's basically no uptake at all, you're just at the wall right away. Very little additional travel, and also a short reset. Overall, a pretty nice trigger, actually. The magazine release is okay. It's held in by a screw in the back that tends to back out as you fire it, so make sure you either Loctite it or screw it down every now and then, otherwise it will come out on you. And then you have a clip here to hold the slide in place. Now you don't actually need to put the slide back at all. I believe you just need the hammer down and then slide out the takedown lever, much like on a 1911, except there's no takedown notch you need to worry about. Then the slide just comes forward and you have it split. You can see that it uses a spring plug system like earlier 1911s. And the hop-up is much like on a 1911 or Maria, many other pistols, the wheel on the bottom there. Finish isn't bad, doesn't seem to have fingerprints on it too much. Putting it back together is basically the reverse, and here I also make the mistake of trying to slide it back to a non-existent takedown notch there. I could have just left it in place, as you'll see shortly. So yeah, if you just leave the slide and it's in battery position, you can then take the takedown lever and reinsert it with no problem. I tried to avoid idiot scratches here. Goes back in, then you just put the clip back on to hold it in place, and you're all set to go again. So what do you guys think of the TT33 Tokarev by Wii? Let me know in the comments. Thanks.